Hello, my name is Austin Little, and I'm a University of Illinois Extension Horticulture Educator, and today on this fine early fall day, we're out at the Jackson County office grounds, and we're just kind of taking a look at the rain garden here that we installed last fall as part of a stormwater management workshop. And so this is kind of the 1 year anniversary of our rain garden out here. And so we planted it last fall about this time of year, and it has come back very strong and very successful. And so it's really successfully established. So this rain garden was planted with a selection of native plants that are really well adapted to water stress. So not only are they able to withstand standing in water, but they're also able to withstand and are resilient to drought conditions. So they're able to tolerate these kind of difficult conditions. And that's what we need for a rain garden. So in this rain garden, we've got a collection of sedges, swamp mallow, black-eyed Susan, and prairie blazing star, echinacea, blue vervain, so blue iris as well. So we've got a neat range of native flowers in our rain garden here. And so looking at it today, we're kind of getting into the fall. Things are starting to kind of go dormant again. And so we're just kind of taking a look, and some things have crept in there over the year. So, but not too much. And really surprisingly over this year, we've had low weed pressure, and that's partly because we used a fine shredded mulch, a triple shredded mulch that has really helped to keep the weed pressure down. We've got a small trench around there to keep the other vegetation from moving in. And just the really successful establishment of these native plants has helped to really cover the ground, especially the sedges, and really suppress weed pressure. But there are a few things that have snuck in. We've got a few bunches of warm season grasses that have kind of crept in. So we need to kind of be persistent on removing those before they go to seed. That's really the key of keeping the weed pressure down. But we're probably gonna do that here today and just kind of pull those out. Now, the really important thing here is to consider the amount of stormwater that this rain garden has been able to recycle over the summer. We had a pretty rainy summer. We had some pretty large rain events, pretty consistent rain events. It's been a wet summer up until pretty much later this year in the early fall. So this rain garden is able to recycle and process about 650, 700 gallons of storm water from a storm every day or every 2 days. So if we kind of think about how many big storms we've had over the year, that really adds up into the thousands of gallons of stormwater runoff that this rain garden has been able to process and use for these really really interesting and quite attractive native plants. So we've got some gray sedge up here, and it's got these kind of neat little spiky balls, and they kind of start as these green kind of succulent spiky balls in the early summer, and now they're kind of turning brown, and they do a really great job of bordering the rain garden. And we've got our black-eyed Susan still here that are kind of going to seed. So these are going to reseed themselves as well and give us more kind of coverage and denser growth. The only things that are still really blooming, we've still got a little bit of the black-eyed Susan, but we've still got a little bit of the swamp mallow, but kind of getting into October, that's really kind of when we're going to see things kind of start to go dormant. So the big color show for the year is winding down for the rain garden. And so we're just going to be doing some fall cleanup for it, probably adding in some mulch for the fall, and just getting ready for it to kind of winterize and rest for the winter. So that's kind of an update here on the Jackson County office rain garden here, and we'll kind of hopefully take another look at it down the road. So thank you, and signing off here.